farmers to increase the production. Now second, use of HYV seeds. Really students, this is also important. Earlier what happened? Farmers did not know about HYV seeds. They used to sow ordinary seeds in their fields, and finally they used to get the low production, or the crops cannot have good quality. But now under Green Revolution, they are quite able to get HYV seeds from different agricultural departments, and they used to sow these seeds, and finally they are getting very good production, having good quality, having good quantity and quality too. Now next is use of artificial methods of irrigation. Really students, earlier what happened? Farmers, they used to wait for monsoon to irrigate their land. For getting water to irrigate their land, they wait for monsoon. When rainfall will occur, then lands, then pieces of land will get irrigated. But now, under Green Revolution, farmers easily come to know about the artificial methods of irrigation. They have installed tube wells. Okay, with the help of tube wells, they are quite capable to have huge quantity of water to irrigate their land time to time. Now they do not wait for monsoon. They do not wait for rainfall. Now they have their own artificial methods of irrigation. They used to follow all these methods, and now they have very good production. Next, use of fertilizers and pesticides. Really students, they use nowadays also manure, but along with the use of manure, they are quite able to use fertilizers and pesticides also, so that their crops can be protected by the different harm done by the insects or other insects, we can say, or other problems of crops. Yes, time to time they use these pesticides and fertilizers properly to have proper growth of their crops. Next is use of modern machines. As I told you in my first point, beta, now farmers are quite able to use the modern techniques by using different machines for their farming activities. They are using tractors, threshing machines, weeding machines, and by using all these machines, now they are able to complete their work very fast. Okay, now they are quite able to save their time. So students, in today's session we came to know about different subtopics. We came to know about the different types of crops, like food crops, non-food crops, plantation and horticulture. In second subtopic, students, we came to know about the global agriculture and different problems faced by the farmers of especially developing countries. And then at last, students, we discussed about the process of Green Revolution, how Green Revolution has become beneficial for all the farmers to have very good production. So that's all for today's session. In next session, again we will meet with the same chapter but with new subtopics. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.